Joining us live right now to talk a little bit more about what Fiserv does is Rich Kirchen from the Milwaukee Business Journal, our partners there. Thanks for being with us. So sure. Yeah, we're going to give a little tease for Ben's story there. What do they do for people that are not familiar with that name of the company that's local?
Well, their name gives a clue, FI meaning financial services. So it's a lot of the things behind the scenes in the bank that you don't think of or you don't see. Some of the electronics and computer and digital services behind ATMs, when you stick your card in the machine at the store. I mean, they do a lot of the backbone and a lot of the networking and a lot of the software for all of those different banking functions.
We're taking a look inside right now at some of the video today from the Fiserv Forum. Why the drama here? I mean, we heard a couple months back that yes, it's Fiserv, no, it's not. There's been other rumors for other companies. Why so much back and forth?
Well, it's called negotiating. You know, I think that was it. I did a blog after both sides denied they had a deal in late May, early June. That's probably because they didn't have a deal at that time. It didn't mean the deal was dead. They just had to do some more negotiating. What I was hearing was they couldn't agree on a price. Most likely, Fiserv wasn't willing to pay what the Bucks wanted, which was $7 million a year or more. Our partners at Sports Business Journal have reported about $6 million a year. That was going to be for a 20-year deal. This is 25, so we're not sure exactly how much.
This will get the company's name out there and more well known. But yeah, what does it do for a company like that to have such a big, I want to say arena, but forum with their name on it in the middle of downtown?
Yes, it's unusual because they are a business-to-business company. Usually, you would have a consumer brand. You'd have the Miller Park, for example, mm-hmm. Miller Beer. So it's twofold. Certainly, they have 24,000 employees around the world, and they see this as something that makes their company relevant, makes them cool. Shows that. They're more than just this boring behind-the-scenes, financial services company. And then the other thing is, it certainly helps with their clients, with banks and credit unions and other financial institutions out there. Now they will have much more name recognition, and it's repeated many, many hundreds of times throughout the year in the media.
Yeah, and taking a little bit of a gamble that it might be the home of the DNC in 2020. Never know.
Correct.
All right. Rich Kirchen with the Business Journal. Thanks for being with us. We appreciate it.